Hi, I'm Matthew Coast, head dating coach and founder at commitmentconnection.com. And today we're going to talk about how men fall in love with you. And I'm going to give you 7 different things to do that can help you get a man to fall in love with you. And number 7 is the most important one by far, so make sure you stay tuned for that. And if this is your first time to our channel, make sure that you go and hit the subscribe button to get more videos on how to have the relationship that you've always wanted to have. So it's really easy to get guys to be attracted to you. I've done some videos on that if you have any challenges on that. It's not hard to get a guy sexually attracted to you. It's easy to get him back into the bedroom, but how do you make him fall in love? How do you connect with his heart? How do you, really make him feel like you're this amazing, special, awesome woman that he wants to be with? Well, we're going to talk about that right now. So number 1 is the first thing that you want to do is you want to be the type of woman that he wants to show off in public, right? And so men want to feel like they have a catch, right? Like they caught this amazing woman. They have this woman that they are proud of, that they, feel like is just this amazingly beautiful, sexy, gorgeous woman that they want to show off to the whole world that she's his, right? And if you go out looking like the type of woman that he thinks is, absolutely amazing and showing off yourself, a lot of guys, unless they get overly jealous, they kind of want that, right? They want to, take you out in public and be like, yeah, this is my girl, she's awesome and beautiful and amazing. Check her out. And so that can be a really powerful thing that can kind of, lock them in, right? And get them to be like, yeah, she's the girl that I want. So number 2 is this woman that is really happy by herself, right? She can be happy. He doesn't have to like work really hard to make you happy, and it's really easy to be around you and to hang out with you and just to spend time with you, right? There's a study done by the Relationship Research Institute that found that if the only way that a guy is going to stay, or the only way a couple is going to stay together, is if there's 5 times as many positive emotions as there are to negative emotions. And if you want him to experience lots of positive emotions, make it easy for him to make you happy, right? Make it easy to be happy. Make it easy for you to be around, for him to be around you, right? And to hang out with you, because the easier he feels that it is to be around you, the more he'll feel like, there's this thing that I talk about in one of my programs where guys just want to be able to hang out around you. Right? They want to be able to just, if they're into some certain hobby, they want to just be able to just hang out there with you. Or if they work from home, or, they do something like drawing, or, who knows what, your guy is into. But he wants to be able to just be able to hang out with you without it having to be this weird interaction where he's, got to do things all the time. And he just wants it to be easy, and the easier going that it is, and the easier it is to be around you and talk to you and spend time with you and tell you anything, the easier it is for him to kind of let down his barrier and his guard and allow himself to fall in love. So number 3 is strong eye contact, right? So there's kind of this, your eyes are the gateway to your soul type of thing. Well, there's also kind of this thing where if you look another person in the eyes, kind of like, not like the weird, creepy staring, type of look in the eyes, but like, like you're really intensely focused on them. Even if it's just for short periods of time, you don't have to like constantly be looking them in the eyes or whatever. But, if you look them in the eyes and you guys connect through the eyes, that can be a very, very intensely intimate way to connect with another human being, and really, really powerful to kind of build that connection between the two of you that makes him feel, it's not even like a conscious thing, right? It's something that he looks into your eyes, and in that connection, there's something that makes him feel a different way and feel more compelled and more in love and, in a deeper connection with you. So number four is having, this is kind of a lifestyle one, is having kind of a life of your own and not being totally smothering over this guy. And here's the reason why, right? So there's kind of a power dynamic in every relationship. It doesn't matter what relationship you're in. There's a power dynamic of who has more power and less power in the relationship. And the more power a guy has, the less likely he's going to feel like you're somebody that he wants to fall in love with, right? And the more power you have, the more he's going to feel like you're somebody that he wants to fall in love with. And so a lot of this, you know, just like the last one, isn't conscious, like isn't in the conscious awareness. It's kind of like just this feeling that he has with you. And so if you have kind of this independence to yourself and you have kind of your own life and you have your own things going on, not so much to the point where you don't have room to have a guy in your life, but to the point where it's not all about him, and you know, you have value and you have power in the relationship, and it's more of an equal footing. The more of a relationship where you have, where there's more of an equal footing, or you know, there you have a little bit of power in that relationship, the more likely, or value in that relationship, the more likely he's going to look at you like this woman that. The more like he's just going to feel like you're this woman that he wants to fall in love with and that he's allowing himself to fall in love with because you're so great and amazing and awesome. So number five, the fifth way, is to focus on things that you have in common. So to talk about your commonalities, to talk about the things that you share together, right? A lot of times when people break up, they talk about like, oh, we didn't have anything in common. And I don't think that necessarily breaking up with somebody, like it really matters. I don't think that necessarily having lots of things in common necessarily determines how good a relationship is going to be. But if you do have things in common, it can kind of amp up like the positive emotional experiences that you have in your relationship. And the more you kind of connect on those things that you do have in common, the easier it'll be for him to feel really, really amazing when he's around you. And kind of like the things we were talking about earlier, it'll make him feel like he has permission to fall in love with you and give himself to you. Because really one of the big things here is that it's not about necessarily, you know, can he fall or can you make him fall? Although, you know, there's a certain extent to which those things can happen. Really, it's about him pulling down this barrier to falling in love, right? This, you know, most people out there, men and women, have a lot of hurt in their lives. So they've been broken up with, they've had their hearts broken before, and they want to be able to, and they go into these relationships and they have this barrier up that stops them from connecting their heart to another person. And you want him to be able to take down that barrier. And the way that you do that is by making him feel like you're somebody that it's safe to take down that barrier with. And so when he feels that, he'll take down that barrier and he'll allow himself to fall in love with you. And that's really what he needs more than anything else. So number six, and like I said, number seven is the most important thing, but number six is a good one too. And it's accentuating the things that really make you unique. So have things, you know, everybody's not going to have everything in common, right? And some people have lots of things that aren't in common at all. And some people have nothing in common. But you want to have things that are different about you, and you want to, you know, have those things that are different that you really enjoy that allow you to shine, you know, and those are things that he can fall in love with you. A lot of times women are afraid of things, and usually they're uniquenesses, right? Uniqueness about themselves, uniqueness about their personality, uniqueness about their bodies, right? And they're afraid of those things because they think that they're flaws. And if a guy really likes you, He's not going to think they're flaws. He's going to find that those are the things that that make him fall in love with you the absolute most. And so you want to be able to kind of open up about those things, whether it's about your personality or whether it's about your body or, you know, whatever it's about. Those are the little things that'll make him really fall in love with you in a deep, deep way. And so number seven, and this is the most important thing that we're going to be talking about here, and it's really believing in him, right? And showing that you believe in him and looking at who he is and not, you know, necessarily falling in love with this idealized person that he wants to become, but believing in his ability to become that man that he really wants to become. And the more that you can kind of look at that and compliment him on traits and characteristics of who he wants to become or who he idealizes himself as being, you know, and saying, yeah, I can see you getting there. I can see you being that man. I can, you know, see you, you know, creating that world that you want to create, whatever this world is that you want to develop, you know, and build. Like, I can see that you're the man for that, you know, and the more you can kind of reinforce that around him, the more he'll feel like, oh my God, this woman is, you know, this absolute special, amazing woman. She's the one for me. Thanks for watching this video. If you're ready to know exactly what to say and do to attract the man and the relationship you've always wanted, click on the button on the right-hand side of this video and go to our website.